We're always looking to make ourselves laugh too. If it makes us laugh, we hope it'll make others laugh.
Hello guys, it's nice to meet you at such a fun place.
Yeah, the best.
Right? Is this one of the coolest places you've ever gotten to do like a junket?
I mean, it's the coolest thing we've ever gotten to do.
Yeah.
Through Hollywood anyway. I mean, like, you can't beat a monster truck. We got to drive the monster trucks earlier this morning.
Okay, I'm jealous. Yeah. We got to be in the back.
You got to ride. Yeah, yeah. So we actually got to drive.
You're lucky you didn't get to ride with us.
While we were driving.
While we were driving.
Yeah,
that wouldn't have been a good thing.
What was it like bringing monster trucks into the movie? Was that something you always kind of knew you wanted to do?
From the very first draft, yeah. Yeah, we really did. We just thought
10 years ago, yeah.
I mean, it checked a lot of boxes, right? It matches Tallahassee's character. He would have been a monster truck fan. You know, it's massive, loud, destructive. Like the idea of sending a truck into a field of zombies, it just made us smile from the very beginning. So yeah, it's always been in.
Revisiting these characters about 10 years later, was it easy to go back and find their voices after doing so many other projects?
Very easy. You know, these characters live within us. You know, Columbus is based on Rhett. You know, he is Columbus. Like it was a treat to open up that file and you know, start writing these characters again, because the voice just kind of flows out of us. It was probably this and Deadpool, it feels like the two easiest scripts we've written. It's taken, you know, not the easiest in the sense of
getting them made,
but actually putting them to paper and finding the character and the voice. Like it felt like putting
very
on
natural
an old comfy sweater. So,
and in the course of this, you know, 10 or so years, what's something maybe you've learned through writing that you wish you kind of had known when you sat down for that first script?
I mean, I think there's no final no, I think I would say. Like, that no project's ever really dead, because this project really did feel dead for a while. Like, we just felt at some point, you know, we're not even really fighting for this to get made anymore. We just don't think it's going to happen. You tend to hear a lot of no's along the way, but there's no final, you know, definitive no. And if you can keep that in the back of your head, like sometimes projects really can, you know, hang in there for even decades, like, which is crazy but true.
And you guys are kind of masters at working in pop culture references and Easter eggs, where a lot of times that stuff can come off so cheesy and you're like, really, why is that in there? So how have you mastered that kind of art? Do you have a favorite one that you've put in and maybe something that you weren't able to put into these movies?
Well, it's interesting. Pop culture does that. The screenwriting rule is you don't put pop culture into movies because it dates it, right? It feels like you're in a particular time and place and in a, you know, again, I don't know what a pop culture reference I could make that would date a movie, but like
Ronnie Millsap in Deadpool. Like,
yeah,
like,
I mean,
great example, but it's like,
right.
You can.
Who was the character from American Idol, that guy who sang, anyway?
There are a million American Idols. So, you know, who's that American Idol guy? They sang, like, everyone ever? Yeah. Like, you know.
See, now you're getting a little slice into kind of how we evolve into a pop culture joke, but what was I saying?
I mean, I think that his point is well taken, which is executives are always saying, don't date the movie. We want it to be timeless. Don't use pop culture. But some of our favorite stuff has a ton of pop culture references, whether it's Seinfeld or you name it. Like our Family Guy, some of our very favorite comedy has pop culture references. So
and pop culture, we feel like, grounds a movie, right? It's like what people talk about when they're sitting around. They talk about pop culture.
Yeah.
So it's like what people talk about when they're, you know, kicking around and drinking a beer. And so
we're always looking to make ourselves laugh too. If it makes us laugh, we hope it'll make others laugh. We also have no rules as to how many audience members we need to please. Like, we're okay with only pleasing a sliver who get that particular joke.
The one rule is just don't please nobody.
So when you're writing jokes for a script, you're more worried about.
Well, there are those moments where you in our movies where there's like a joke and you'll hear like eight people in the theater laughing really hard and everybody else.
Those
is
are
dead
my
silent.
Favorite
like,
ones, you know, quite like, honestly.
Because we will tell niche jokes. If you tell enough of them, you know, you can get away with that.